As you know, for the last three Sundays, different ones have been lighting the candles. Those that may not have been here, the center candle is Christ-centered. The next candle was hope. Next one was love and joy. Today, we will light the peace candle and speak a little bit on peace. bottom of our bulletin, it says, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." In Webster's, it says, peace says freedom from war or fighting, to live in peace with all countries, an agreement or a treaty to end war, law and order, the rights were disturbing the peace, calm or quiet, to find peace of mind. At peace, free from war and fighting. Holding one peace or keep one's peace is to be silent. Keep the peace to make sure that the law is not broken. Make peace to end war and fighting. And peaceable. Pawn of peace, not fighting, peaceable. Peace Corps, an agent of the U.S. Department of the States that send volunteer teachers and workers to help undeveloped countries. It says peaceful. Freedom from noise or disorder. Quiet, calm, the peaceful countryside, fond of peace, not fighting, are peaceful people, are fit for time of peace. Peaceful trade between nations. Peacemaker, a person who makes peace as by stopping the fight or war. So that's what Webster has. We'll see what the Bible says. I always consider myself at peace when the kids were growing up and they all got into bed and was asleep, and then things got real peaceful. And then today, when we get through eating supper at night, and I get in my recliner, and Joanne gets in hers, then I'm at peace. I heard Brother Gary say that he's got a big recliner over there, and when he gets in it, he's at peace.
Amen.
A lot of faith. This is says Bible promises for peace. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. That's I'm not going to say where all these scriptures are, but thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusts in thee. Now the Lord of peace himself giveth you peace always by all means. The Lord be with you always. When a man's way pleases the Lord, he maketh even his enemies to be at peace with him. Great peace has they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, Give I unto you, let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid. Therefore, being justified in faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, shall keep our hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. And let the peace of God rule in your heart, in which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. It's not the absence of problems that gives us peace. It's God's presence with us in the problems. Jesus sent his disciples into the world, ordered them to preach the gospel to every creature, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. And Apostle Paul wrote, for I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any power, neither height nor depth, or anything else in all creatures will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus and Lord and Lord. What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? And to paraphrase this, if God is for us, who cares who's against us?
Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came in haste, and they found Mary and Joseph, and the woman lying in the manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which he had told them concerning this journey. And all those who heard it marveled at all the things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. When the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and said.
This past month, we have been celebrating the Advent candles, which has a meaning of a representation of, has a meaning and representation of expectation. And we began with hope, and each of us need hope. It's something that we strive for. Today, Michael's sitting back here, just came in from basic training and serving our country. And we put hope in our military, so thank you for serving.
Yeah.
Many of you all served in the military things. And things we go out and do, we look for hope, we need hope. We want it, we strive for it. And then the next one was love. Today our society's got love a little misrepresented. We've got love a little twisted. But we say we love our little cat or dog. We love chocolate ice cream and pecan pies, and I love my wife, I love my husband, I love my children, I love my Lord. But God showed us what the true love was really about. He said, I'm going to give you unadulterated love. I'm going to give you love in the purest form. I'm going to give you love that is beyond comprehension. I'm going to give you love and show you love. So much to the point that I'm willing to lay down my life and shed my blood for you. I always wonder, if I say I love the Lord so much and I trust Him and I love, put so much faith and trust in Him, would I be willing to lay down my life for someone? Would you be willing to stand in front of somebody to take something that was meant for harm? We as men, we are trained and being brought up in our life to protect our women folk. And when there's a screech in the middle of the night, it's us men are supposed to get up and go out and do the things. And do we do it out of love? I hope so. Guys, ladies and gentlemen, we need love. We need it in the purest form, and we need to show it in the purest way. Yes, it's good that we love our ice cream and desserts and stamps and seeing the kids smile and those things. Yes, all of it, but we need the purest love from the form that God shows us. And I'm not going to get into it today because of time, but there are so many different avenues of God's love that He showed upon us. But He says the greatest love that He has, that He shed His love for us, His blood, His love for you and me. And then joy. And each one of these ladies and gentlemen who have lit all these candles and have done an excellent job, and I thank you for just giving us a different perspective, because this is my first Christmas with you all, and to see and to learn how you all think, and just so good to see all of them come from a different perspective. And they came in here and they talked about joy. And you know, Brother Jim, him and this came. They brought in a form of joy to show us what joy is really and truly all about. He said that, yes, there for a second when you get your new car or your big screen TV or you're able to buy something with monetary gifts, yes, there is a joy that's there for just a moment. But then when the fuse breaks or there's a dent in your car, all of a sudden, that joy has just turned to mundane. But the Bible that we have been reading and the story of the Advent we've been learning, there is a joy that makes us want to jump up and shout when our two ladies sang that song, Mary, Did You Know? Oh, my heart was pounding. I knew right then I'd been to church on Christmas Day in the most nicest way. It was just so exciting. Man, Mary, did you know? that she didn't comprehend. You read the story, says she pondered all the things in her heart. And those of you who have seen Mel Gibson's movie about Jesus in his last few days, last few hours, if you will, of being alive as a human being before he went to the cross. You know, we saw the things that Mary finally understood that all this was to come about. Even in that darkest hour, she knew that there was joy that was going to be for all of mankind. As we read all the Christmas stories and we start to meditate upon them and we look into their meanings, we find that when the angels told Joseph and Mary and the shepherds and all those who were involved with this birth and conception of Jesus Christ, they said, you know, he was going to be Emmanuel, God with us. He's going to take away the sins of the world. He's going to come and do things as never before. He's going to give us hope. He's going to give us love. And he's going to give us joy. But today, congregation, I'm here to tell you, we need his peace. Why do we need it? I do not know who designed the Advent candle. I'll give it to the Catholics, Catholicism. I'm not for sure where it came from, and that's not important. But I'm glad that they did it in the way that they did, because I followed whoever system it was, whoever designed it, and they brought peace as the last candle. And listen, guys, you know, with the world going in a chaos right now, I was listening to one of the newscasters this morning, and he said this: we've got to have an honest debate. We need to talk about the things that are happening in America. We need to talk about the things that are around the world. We need to talk about the economics and all the different things that are going on in all the different communities around the world. We need to sit down and talk about this and have an open, honest decision. And you and I know that, as I was talking to Ms. Claudia last night about Iran and just, you know, going into the hospital on Christmas and the issues that each one of us in this room, we could stand and face, and we could have a tear-shedding time of the hurt and pain and each one of us have experienced in our own personal life. Amen? But guys, there's something about that peace. Yes, my world may fall apart. Yes, I may be diagnosed with cancer. Yes, I may have trouble with my finances. Yes, all of my physical and medical and all the issues of my life might be bombarding me. But because I've experienced the hope and the love and the joy of Jesus Christ, I have found true peace. Amen, amen, and amen. You can take my world away from me. Whatever you want to do, you do whatever it is you want to. But I'm here to tell you, as your preacher, I got peace that runs from the top of my head to the soles of my feet, from fingertip to fingertip. I've got a peace that surpasses all understanding. I've got a peace no matter what happens, it goes up and down. Most of you all know that I work in the prison system, and I work in the toughest prison that the ADC has to offer. And I walk up and down the hallways each and every day, and I go into the barracks, I go to death row, I go to the places of people where no one wants to go because of these hardened criminals. But I'm here to tell you, I go with my head high and my chest out, with a pep in my step and a smile on my face and a song in my heart, because I've experienced the true peace of God. What can any man do to me?
Amen.
And I ask you, do you know that peace? Oh, listen, you've got to have that intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. Yes, you've got to experience that love, for God so loved the world. Let's all stand together. We're going to sing, "Oh, How I Love Jesus." Is that true? Do you need to come to this altar? This is between you and God.
Oh,
10-11 hour ride. I'm going some way different. So I do appreciate your prayers because I have them. I ain't even going to lie. I ain't going to lie to you. I let it roll. And so I need your prayers. All right? And if I don't see you again, I will see you in heaven.
Amen.
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 Let's pray for Barry. I know. It's because of Matthew. Oh, does everybody know who Matthew Head is? I didn't know. He didn't say Matthew. Matthew.
Well, a couple weeks ago, Brother Gary was over at the store, and he's always. Never, you know, he never shuts up. We weren't even talking about this subject, but he came out and told me, he says, the church is thinking about doing something for me for Christmas. Just forget it. Just, I don't want anything done. So I just want to let you know what I'm doing.
Amen. Thank you. You're good.
Now, we did pick up love offering, but I know how hard it is you are. So I thought I'd come up here this morning and present this as a motion that you accept this love offering. You can't turn it down by turning down and leaving the church. So I need a motion.
So moved.
Second.
All those in favor?
Amen.
Yes.
Y'all know.
We hope you take this. Go in peace.
Thank you all very much, all right?
You know,
I told you I wasn't going to wear a tie this Sunday. I don't wear ties anymore. But I don't know if y'all are going to be able to hear this. Can you hear it? One of our people that listens to our sermon on the internet sent me this tie and request, would you please wear my tie on Christmas?
Amen.
So, there is a tender side to me, all right? So, man, on behalf of the church, thank y'all very much. You know, y'all are very good people. And I do appreciate your prayers. I wasn't going home for Christmas, but you lady folks got a way of having your way, and my wife said, she knows how the ABC works. She says, you know, you've got a couple of holidays there, and you can drive. Won't you come home? So I don't know if I'll make it home for Christmas, okay? But I'll be there as well, okay? So I do appreciate your prayers. Any other word of testimony before we close? All of you who have come out. What's that, man?
We love you.
We love you, too. I do. Any word of testimony before we go? Brother Mike, thank you very much for serving our country. Y'all be sure to say hi to Mike. He's in uniform today. Amen. I got to meet him for the first time the other day, and it's good to see our young people standing up and serving our country. Because of what they do, we get to do this.
Right.
If we think we're doing what they do, we're going to end up stopping doing this. Okay. Because evil will take over. All minds are clear? Are you ready to go home? Mm-hmm. Brother Pat. How's that? Was that a short enough sermon?
Praise the Lord.
Hey, praise the Lord. Would you close us out in prayer?
Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this special time of year that we can come and be with our families and exchange gifts and remember the perfect gift your son does. Watch over us and be with us for the rest of this week. Amen.
Amen.